Welcome everybody to the last session of the day and of this long 3 days meeting. We have now Dr. Marius Provieri as a speaker, and he will talk about the project Snapshot. Snapshot is a project that comes from the BlueMed community and is carrying out a particular experiment, which is to assess what is the negative impact, let's say, so the reduction of human impact on the environment. And this is not related to the several months of lockdown. And so what is peculiar of this project is to try to measure the effect of a reduced impact. So it is not easy to quantify an incremental impact like an oil spill or any other impact on the environment, but it is not trivial to measure a reduction of such impact. So this is the exercise that Snapshot is doing, and Mario is the coordinator of Snapshot, and he will tell us about the results so far. Mario, go ahead.
Okay, good morning, Fabio. Please confirm me that you can see my screen.
Yes.
Can you screen? Okay.
Yes.
Okay, good morning, everybody. Thank you, Fabio. And thank you for inviting me to present these preliminary results of Snapshot, which is a project launched during the last phase of BlueMed, involving a part of the BlueMed community, and which is devoted to a synoptic assessment of human pressures on key Mediterranean hotspots, in particular with a vision on a pandemic and post-pandemic, on a glance on the pandemic and post-pandemic marine environment. Indeed, in the last 2-3 months, were published about 170 papers on sectorial journals dedicated to the impact of the continental lockdown. We are talking about the first continental lockdown, March to May, more or less 2020. And these papers are generally focused on the air, in particular quality of air, potential reduction in CO2 due to the reduction in transport mass and so on. Very limited amount of work, a very limited number of papers have been published about the marine environment. And this is our exercise. In particular, we could synthesize the main goals of Snapshot in these 4 points. It tests the evolution of the anthropic impact on the marine coastal system following the lockdown in Mediterranean areas, and I will show you in particular the main results related to Italian countries, in particular with a specific attention to the high urban air or industrial, high density industrial area. Quantifying in a synoptic way the good environmental status of the sea at the end of the lockdown phase, integrate measures from scientific networks observation and adding ad hoc measures in coastal hotspots area, qualitative, and also adding a qualitative evidence from observation of citizens according to the local ecological knowledge approach. As you can see, we tried to create a mixture of experimental information and the socio-economic information. This is directly exactly at the core of the project. And finally, to build a shared vision among different actors by engaging citizens of the mapped areas and relevant stakeholders, fishermen, and so on. The idea is to create a sort of model to identify cause to effect relationship between anthropic impact and response of the marine environment. Actually, in its dramatic situation, the dramatic situation of the pandemia, we are trying to exploit the opportunity of a giant natural experiment usefully to better understand kinetics and dynamics of the marine system, then the response of the marine ecosystem to anthropic forcing, and to propose alternative to a classical business as usual development and approach to economy. We selected a number of areas where we think the signal to noise ratio for the parameters that we investigated are at the highest level, and in particular at the mouth of the most important rivers in Italy and in near semi-enclosed areas. So we selected, for example, in the Northern Adriatic Sea, the Venice Lagoon, the Po River, the most of the Po River, the Taranto Gulf with an important steel plant, one of the largest in Europe, occur. Then a number of area in the southern Italy, the Arno River, and I'll show you in particular some interesting results exactly from this area in the northern part of the Tyrrhenian Sea with the Liguria region. We started a number of oceanographic cruises just some days after the lockdown. So we are talking about the middle of May in 2020. And then we continued our sampling activity 1, 3, 6 months after the lockdown. And we are working to plan the final oceanographic cruise in the different areas. So how to manage and how to extract, to capture the effect of the lockdown in the middle of a large natural variability generally associated in the marine environment to the different parameters. So we used an integrated approach of numerical circulation model for identifying sampling areas, observing and model for atmospheric transport, so just to identify the main sources of variability, for example, for contaminants at sea, satellite observation for identification of fronts, coastal plumes, and site-specific dynamics, just to identify the best location, the best sites to capture the possible effect. It's a challenge, of course, the possible effect of the lockdown. Ocean core satellite, just to measure that in remote chlorophyll concentration, total suspended matter, and temperature at sea surface, and so on. And then coupling all the experimental information, all this experimental information with socio-economic in data, socio-economic information on land connected to the various anthropogenic activity that could produce an effect on the marine environment. So a number, a very important number of parameters were measured and make part of our data collection, starting from the classical tracers, sediment load, temperature, salinity, pH, fluorescence, EH in the column water, nitrogen, phosphorus profiles, particulate in seawater, a different component of the organic matter, in particular TOC, the dissolved organic carbon, CDOM, and the carbon isotope composition of the particulate organic carbon. On the other side, we selected a number of parameters useful to identify, to capture, I would say, changes in lifestyle on land during the lockdown phase. And so at sea, we measured microbiological pollutants, surface active agents, microplastics, noise and maritime traffic, heavy metals, and persistent organic pollutants, and of course, SARS-CoV-19 and RNA remains in seawater. And then the potential impact on the marine ecosystem. So on the phyto and zooplankton community, abundance and the structure of a microbial community, and of course, fisheries. So just a couple of results, more than a couple. This is, for example, the distribution of DOC, dissolved organic carbon, at the mouth of the Arno River in the central part of Italy. And you can see, you can immediately identify an important change compared with information from 2015, with significant change and a significant decrease in DOC content in seawater of about 26 to 27%. And the reduction of these different 3-4 months after the lockdown. This is a crucial point of our history because The similar results have been measured in the other cluster areas, and in particular, DUC is at the core of the microbial loop and also is a principal component of a complex system of contaminants, in particular heavy metals and part of persistent organic, pollutants in seawater. So it's a principal micro variable useful to understand the evolution of the marine ecosystem. Here you see, for example, the distribution of a number of heavy metals in dissolved phase, in particular copper, nickel, zinc, and lead in the Gulf of Taranto, where important, again, important steel plant occurs. And you can see that after the lockdown, just after the lockdown, an increasing trend of concentration of contaminants could be identified, could be shown. So the effect of the lockdown was important, relevant, and measurable in this specific area. This is a similar trend measured in the heavy metals concentration in particulate phase, more possibly more connected, more related to urban traffic input and industrial input by air. A similar trend also in the distribution of polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons directly connecting again to the urban traffic and the industrial activity. Activities. This is a very short synthesis about the concentration of arsenic, chromium, and copper in particulate measured in the Venice Lagoon, where again you can where it's possible to evidence a strong difference, an important statistical difference between the first oceanographic cruise just after the lockdown, just immediately after the lockdown, and 3 months after that event. So if an important part of our measurements are connected to analysis of contaminants, an important aspect of snapshot is also connected to the effect of underwater wall noise in a number of sampling sites. So you can see in this part of the picture, underwater noise, analysis of underwater noise in strict collaboration with researchers and colleagues of the Soundscape project and European project, particularly focused on the Northern Adriatic Sea. And again, I'll show you some results in the Venice Lagoon, data collected inside the Venice Lagoon and outside the Venice Lagoon in the platform Acqua Alta, and it's evident a really giant, dramatic decrease in underwater noise practically to all the frequencies with respect to same value measured in the same season in 2020, in 2020. So an important change in the amount of underwater noise measured, possibly reasonably possibly connected to the decrease in maritime traffic and the urban traffic in this area. Similar results outside of the lagoon, and here you can see mainly in the lower frequency range an important difference, a dramatic difference of about 30 to 50% of underwater noise measured during the lockdown, just after the lockdown phase, and during the following period. What about fisheries? We started working on with the IES data just to monitor the dynamics of target and non-target stocks, mainly in the North Adriatic areas. And you can see very preliminary results obtained using a big data analysis, also connected it to Google information. And you can see that in 2019, the distribution of a fish effort was more relevant with respect to the same period in just after the lockdown phase, the last lockdown phase. And this is also directly connected to a significant impact on the distribution of IUCN species, biodiversity, and abundant species in the same area of the Adriatic Sea. How to connect the socio-economic information with environmental data? First, our idea is to provide a common framework to develop interpretative and predictive models, but the main focus, the final aim, is to set up the basis for a long-term exploitation of the project in view of a lengthy-based science to policy in the post-COVID era. The idea is to go beyond the business as usual approach to economy, mainly in the blue area, in the coastal area, just to propose something different in terms of a sustainable development. So the idea is to develop a common strategy to define main forcing conditions, cause effects, relationship, in particular connecting a number of anthropic pressures. You can see, for example, the touristic presence during the lockdown practically reduced it to zero, and an obvious relative impact on the distribution of parameter on contaminants, for example, in the marine, in the same coastal areas. This is, for example, an example of the reduction of transport load at country level, but also an important impact on the industry and services. And the idea is to create a sort of a complex model, and I'll show you in the next slide how to do that, to connect in terms of quantitative numbers, cause and effect relationship, in cause and effect, just to provide using information for future development. And this is the concept of a sort of a hyperspace anthropopause dynamic, and this is the evolution of the parameters controlling the anthropogenic pressures and state variables that we are measuring in time, just to start working on the trajectories of the evolution of these small spaces in time, and to analyze in sort of a dynamical complex system the kinetic of hysteresis of our system, the dynamic response of the system, and support policy decisions. Last but not least, my last slide is connected to a complete approach, not only in terms of experimental data, the classical approach that scientists follow to understand the effect in the marine environment, and we complement the approach with a specific analysis of social media, in particular Twitter, Facebook, and so on, in the studied area just to understand the perception of the citizen living there, and possibly to use this semi-quantitative and in some way qualitative information just to integrate the approach we are following to understand what's happening really there, not only in terms of classical parameters, but a complete vision about the effect of the lockdown on the marine environment. Thank you very much for your attention.
Grazie. Well, thank you. Thank you very much, Mario. If it was a normal meeting in presence, this presentation would be followed by at least 20 minutes of lively discussion. There are so many points to talk about. Unfortunately, this is not possible. So I invite everybody who has questions to contact you, and I'm sure you will have you will find the time to answer. So rather than staying in Mario's hyperspace, we go to the conclusion of the meeting. So I have a few things to say in the end to wrap these 3 days up. So on the first day, we pivoted our activity on the results of the BlueMed Young Communication Ambassadors. And this is a way to promote the dialogue with colleagues also colleagues from different seas, not only the sides of the Mediterranean, and colleagues from the Atlantic Ocean. And the idea is to offer a broader connection of networks and offer the young people a key role as an agent of change for one planet, one ocean. And in this direction, I remind that we just launched and will have in the next few weeks the Blue Medal Hackathon as an important step. Then we talked about the achievement of the pilot initiative on a healthy, plastic-free Mediterranean Sea. And yesterday we showcased all the results of this. And also yesterday we showed the results of all the BlueMed strategic actions that are addressed in the implementation plan, which is a concentration of the 13 priorities we briefly described. So these four key strategic actions in the implementation plan talk about the need of implementing a joint observing system at Mediterranean scale, focus on climate change, because of the hot spot of climate change is here, work on how to preserve biodiversity in relation to the use of the sustainable use of biological resources and resources in general. And then we focus also on renewable energies and in relation to an approach to maritime spatial planning. We can learn lessons in the Mediterranean on maritime spatial planning that can then be used in broader areas and on larger scales. So a very vibrant call for joint uptake by countries and key stakeholders pervaded this virtual session, and with the need of scaling up all the activities at the at least pan-Mediterranean scale. Today was the third day, and it was very interesting to see all together the results of the four startup actions, which are a major achievement of the our BlueMed activities. And just a few minutes ago, we had the presentation of Snapshot, which is another major result. All this after the great presentation we had at the opening this morning, talking about climate and the relation with peace in the Mediterranean by Gramenos Mastroianni. So it may look counterintuitive that we are closing a four-year project, launching so many activities into the future, but I think that a good project has to do this and leave this legacy behind. So it took us time to, but the building work carried out in BlueMed CSA has prepared the ground for the development of future actions and for future generations. And throughout the 3 days of this event, we also gathered some concrete answers. As John Bell warmly reminded us, and we deeply thank him for this, the destination of this journey will enable the Green Deal transformation by 2050, and also in the Mediterranean, we have to do our share in this direction. The BlueMed initiative, which we supported as BlueMed CSA, will continue to work for the One Mediterranean, coping with the needs of the sea and filling some gaps that are still there, like the we need more effort on the open data issue, we need to link economic and social sciences, we need to overcome the great complexity of the so-called regulatory barriers and all the Pandora box of the legislation differences among countries. So there are a number of policy needs to be kept informed via science-based evidence. So we gain momentum and for the work we have done, and the moment is also very promising and favorable at European level because of this new European Green New Deal that is developing. Of course, we discussed our BlueMed strategic research and innovation agenda and the implementation plan, and it is important to show how these pieces of work has already been used to feed into the mission, in particular the Starfish mission, and in the Blue Economy partnerships, where the experience of regional cooperation will find a home and the regional basing approach. So a fruitful dialogue was developed with the JPI Ocean during the last 4 years, in particular on the definition of good environmental status and the contribution that science can provide to a better definition of the Marine Strategy Framework Directive, which is the key directive for the maintenance of a healthy ocean everywhere in Europe. And of course, we participated to the cross-basin dialogue with a particular effort on the underwater noise that is recognized as a key aspect in the Mediterranean ecosystem because of all the traffic pressure we know about. So in partnership with the WestMed, we joined an important project on the Mediterranean emission control area and have jointly organized two workshops on the crucial theme of sustainable tourism. And you remember how important this tourism is at the regional level. So the Interreg program also offered a key framework for supporting a strategic action in the blue biotech. All these synergies allowed us to prepare and scale up even at global level. And BlueMed is partnering with IOC, UNESCO and UNEPMAP and offering and support and playing a role in developing the Mediterranean program for the UN decade that just started for the so-called Ocean Decade, Ocean Science for Sustainable Development. Policy frameworks targeting the area and country synergies have been recently reinforced with the signature of the UFM Blue Economy Declaration. And we must not forget that the European Commission confirmed the commitment to keep hosting and supporting the Euro-Mediterranean Group of Senior Officials steering the BlueMed initiative. A very good news in the perspective of the scaling up of all the actions at the Mediterranean level. This is very important that this initiative is may go on exploiting all the work that has been done so far. So having said that, I believe that one of the major strengths lays in the fact that a lot has been returned also to national communities. So each partner has brought in his own country results from the project. So in terms of connection and discussion across sectors and disciplines, co-design future actions as well, because of the opportunity offered to raise the voice at Mediterranean level. This meeting had a great participation. Yesterday, 280 people from some 20 countries. Today, a little bit smaller number, but still above 150. And despite the condition of the meeting in remote, which is not so favorable, at least for people of my generation. And as a CNR, we, and I personally also guarantee the intention to keep supporting the initiative in this transition. So to keep the team working as BlueMed and to keep support to what we've done so far. So we have in mind, and what we generate is a sort of a team of teams that we have built at different levels, and this is going to support future activities towards Horizon Europe. So now it is time to go with the thankings. And there are many people to thank. And so I've written down, and I already apologize if I by chance forgot someone, but I hope not. So first of all, the colleagues of the project management team here in Rome and in Italy, I mean, the closest collaborators, Margherita, Andrea, Mario, Elena, Angelo, Fedra, Luigi, and Gianmarco. The communication team of Alba and Rita, together with our Greek colleagues. The staff of the Earth System Science Department, Paolo, Francesca, Isabella, and the others. The CNR press office, Marco, Anna, Cecilia, and colleagues. The BlueMed CSA partners, and in particular the steering committee. I can only mention the steering committee for time reasons, like Abram, Esther, Monica, and Carlos from Spain, Jean-François and Amélie from France, Poppy, Erasmia, Celia, Nikos from Greece, including Vangelis for particularly his inspiring work at the beginning of the project and the definition of the project. And then George and Tamara from Malta, Vlado from Slovenia, George from Cyprus, and Ivica from Croatia, and our Portugal colleagues, and all the administrative staffs in all teams. And there is a lot of administration going on in this kind of European projects. So we also have to thank deeply the BlueMed Initiative national delegates and Fabio Fava at first and all the other colleagues. The European Commission, John Bell, Sigi, Elisabetta Balzi, Luca and Christos from Digimare, and our officers, Marta and Miguel. And then the Union for the Mediterranean Secretariat with Alessandra and Giuseppe. The platform's coordinator, the national pivot, and members of the national communities that provided a valuable work and contribution in each platform. Then we have to thank the coordinators and networks of all the startup actions, the young ambassadors, of course, the coordinators of relevant projects, and initiatives that have been that we have been consulting. So last but not least, the CNR technical support, Valentina and Vittorio, for making this event possible. And of course, all of you, all the speakers, the panelists, the moderator, the chairs, the illustrator, who made me look 10 years younger, I'm particularly thanking for this, and the interpreters and all the participants. And now, a super thank to Margherita for the work, the vision, the strength, the continuity in keeping us concrete, because sometimes we diverge, and on time, on the precise action, and on the content, and on the quality of what we all achieved together. So I'd like to quote to close the sentence that Lina Tode offered us. If you don't know where you are going, you'll probably end up somewhere else, because this is a rather zen sentence, which I didn't know, and I liked it. And I think that BlueMed tried to show a way where to go, and this is our legacy for the work to come. Thank you very much. Ah, il pesce, è vero, l'ho dimenticato. Sì. No, è che è così difficile senza un po' di...